अस्सलाम वालेकुम व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू सियासत इंग्लिश न्यूज़। आई एम एमन उमर। हैदराबाद मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट एंड ऑल इंडिया मजलिस इत्तेहादुल मुस्लिमीन चीफ असदुद्दीन अवैसी ऑन संडे रिएक्टेड टू द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट्स प्रपोजल टू क्रिएट अ नेशनल डेटाबेस ऑफ बर्थ्स एंड डेथ्स। ऑन हिज ट्विटर अकाउंट अवैसी एलिजेड दैट द डेटाबेस विल बी यूज्ड फॉर द एनआरसी एनपीआर एक्सरसाइज। ही ऑल्सो सेड दैट द प्रपोजल वायलेट्स आर्टिकल 324 of the Indian Constitution that gives independence to the Election Commission of India. His reaction was a result of the government's proposal to amend the Registration of Births and Deaths Act 1969 to require the Registrar General of India to maintain a national database of registered births and deaths. The database may be used after the central government's approval for updating the NPR, electoral rolls, Aadhaar, passport, etc. A consumer court here directed Apollo Hospitals to pay 10,000 rupees to a complainant for charging registration fees, which it called an unfair trade practice. The major healthcare player was also asked to pay 3,000 rupees as cost of litigation as well. The ruling issued by the District Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission also asked Apollo Hospitals to also discontinue collecting 200 rupees as registration fee from patients forthwith. The Commission's order, dated 4th of October, also noted that the Jubilee Hills branch of Apollo Hospital was also penalized by the Hyderabad GST department for issuing same bills without mentioning GST number in the invoice. Mesco College of Pharmacy has allegedly been coercing parents and students to pay the full course fees lump sum at the time of the admissions. Parents and students have alleged that during the admission interview into the B Pharmacy and PharmD, they have been asked to pay the full fees at the time of admission or else pay in two installments with an extra amount. For PharmD, a six-year course, if the fee is being paid in two installments, then the parents reportedly have to pay 1 lakh rupees extra. And if they want to pay the B Pharm fee in two installments, then also they would have to pay 1 lakh rupees extra. Speaking to Siyasat.com over the phone, a parent said that the college authorities have behaved very rudely with him, insulting him in front of his daughter, and reportedly said if they are unable to pay the full fee or half fee with extra charges, then go to other colleges. An official of the college who didn't want to be quoted confirmed the news that the college is in fact charging the fees lump sum or in two installments with unnecessary additional charges. The Directorate of Public Health and Family Welfare has begun its search for people who gave amiss to the second dose of the COVID-19 vaccine. It is said that 30% of the fresh COVID-19 cases reported in Telangana are due to partially vaccinated people, which is a serious cause of concern for the Department of Public Health. It is to be noted that approximately 36 lakh people across the state have skipped their second dose, among which 6,36,262 people are from Hyderabad, while Medchal and Rangareddy districts have reported 4,90,582 and 4,77,539 people respectively who are semi-vaccinated. Negligence and hesitancy regarding vaccination have also played a major role in preventing people from taking a jab. It is reported that most people under Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation and its peripheral areas have skipped the vaccine due to the aforementioned reasons. Stand-up comedian Munawar Farooqi has said that he is receiving several threat calls and not being allowed to work. His statement comes after his shows in Gujarat and Mumbai were recently cancelled following threats from members of the Hindutva group, the Bajrang Dal. In an interview with NDTV India, the comedian said if the country's youth can decide who to vote, they can also decide what to watch. Earlier this year, Farooqi, who was arrested and was in jail for a month in Indore for allegedly cracking anti-Hindu jokes, said he is not being allowed to work even after the Supreme Court granted him bail. The comedian said he cancelled his shows because the safety of the audience matters the most to him. He called the cancellation unfortunate and stated that a lot of wrongs are happening in the country. भारतीय किसान यूनियन लीडर राकेश तिकायत ऑन मंडे सेड द सेंटर हैज टाइम टिल 26th ऑफ नवंबर टू रिपील द कंटेंशियस फार्म लॉस आफ्टर विच द फार्मर प्रोटेस्ट अराउंड दिल्ली वुड बी इंटेंसिफाइड. इट हैज टू बी नोटेड दैट 26th नवंबर would mark 1 year of the ongoing farmers' protest at Delhi's border points of Singhu, Tikri and Ghazipur. The protests are led by farmers' collective Samyukta Kisan Morcha. Farmers' Union, BKU, whose supporters are encamping at Ghazipur on the Delhi-Uttar Pradesh border, is also a part of the SKM. Tikayat, the BKU national spokesperson, have said the central government has time till 26th of November, and after that, from the 27th of November, the farmers will reach the border at the movement sites around Delhi on tractors from villages and strengthen the tents at the movement site with solid fortifications. Air Arabia, the United Arab Emirates' low-cost airline, will launch direct flights to Indian destinations from 3rd of November 2021, with tickets starting at 499 dirhams, that is 10,179 Indian rupees. The airline announced that it would operate direct flights to Kochi, Kozhikode and Thiruvananthapuram in Kerala. The first flight from Abu Dhabi to Kochi departs on 3rd of November at 10:55 p.m. Bookings can be made through the website. Earlier on 28th of October 2021, the Indian airline Air India Express has announced to start flights from Al Ain in Abu Dhabi to Kozhikode in Kerala from 4th of November 2021. India's Minister of State for External Affairs V. Muralidharan said on 27th of October that travel restrictions from India may be eased in the coming days in view of the significant drop in COVID-19 cases. That's it for today. Thank you, viewers.